I'm Alexis Van Hurkman, and welcome to Resolve in a Rush, where you'll learn DaVinci Resolve grading and finishing techniques in under 5 minutes. In this lesson, I'm going to show you a fun little creative technique. Very quick, very easy. It's something that longtime Resolve users probably already know about, but new users have probably completely missed because it's one of those obscure controls available in Resolve that is frankly easy to miss. I'm going to show you how to antique this image using a particular set of controls called the YSFX controls. And these controls can be seen in the color page in the custom curves. So if you've ever wondered why there's a little slider handle to the left of the curve editor, these are the YSFX controls. To use them creatively, what we're going to do is we're going to unlink the custom curves. And to do that, you just click the button corresponding to which curve you want to adjust, Y, R, G, or B. And you'll be adjusting that particular color channel by itself. Going to R, all these sliders really are contrast controls for that particular color channel. So if I drag this down, you can see that I'm actually adjusting the contrast of the red channel. And you can see that interaction happening over here on the waveform graph. So by compressing the contrast of the red channel, I'm basically lifting the bottom of the red channel and lowering the top of the red channel, I get this kind of groovy little compressed red effect. I can go over into the blue channel and adjust that by a slightly different amount. I can go into the green channel. And by and large, leave that be. And then maybe I want to go to the Y channel. And I can just lower the contrast there, wash it out. I'm going for kind of an old postcard look here. That's really all there is to it. It's really quick, and it's just a way to trash your different channels to create something that looks a little bit different. If I wanted to lower blue a lot, leave red up at the top, and then lower my green, I can get a completely different kind of washed out look. So there you have it. Another set of controls you can experiment with to create different kinds of random looks for those times when you need to pull something a little special out of your back pocket for whatever reason. I hope this has been helpful to you. My name is Alexis Van Hurkman. If you want more training about DaVinci Resolve, I strongly recommend you check out all of my titles at rippletraining.com. Thanks for watching.